Hi everyone, finally I changed apartment with my family and this is my new YouTube studio. In this video I'm going to cover SharePoint Copilot agents. You can have multiple agents expanding the capability of Copilot in SharePoint as well. You can target specific site collections or document libraries, even folders if you want, so you can easily grab information around and along multiple files that you have in your document library. So you can, in just few clicks, create an FAQ page or just get information when you have many files. All right, let me show you every step and let's see how you can expand the capability of Copilot in SharePoint as well. Let's go. Here I am in SharePoint. This is a communication site, the global HR communication site. I also applied an existing template. Now, the first thing that we can notice in the upper right corner is a new icon available. This is Copilot. I have this icon here available because I have a Copilot license assigned to my user. Now, opening the Copilot panel, this will generate immediately a Copilot agent for this site. So the target is the entire site. It means that I can start to play with this Copilot agent by asking something, for example, create FAQ based on these resources. And this is pretty important, especially when you start in a new project or when you have an onboarding process. So you need to get the information that you need to get onboarded. So here are several information that are available just by asking to my agent to get an FAQ. This will help me to start to move first steps in this site. I can even select this option, suggest next steps for me, and this will help me as well get more familiar with this, with the content of this site. So everything is showing up, stakeholders, for example, innovation and development, personal development, all the things that are on this site are now grounded from this Copilot agent. Very, very cool. So other things that I can do is opening again this drop down is seeing other Copilot agents that I created in other places. It means in other SharePoint sites or document library, because you can create Copilot agent that ground only document library if you want. So what I can do here in this panel is starting the creation of a new Copilot agent. For example, I can clean up my chat history by clicking here new chat, or I can even completely delete the Copilot history. This is important if you want to clean up the list down below in this section, chat history. All right, so it seems that we can start to create our first Copilot agent. So this is the first one that you can find when you open the Copilot panel. This is the default Copilot agent that target and ground the entire site. Before to create a new Copilot agent, I would like to show you in the site contents of this site the document library site assets. This is very important because here there will be a new folder created when I create a new Copilot agent. Now, to create a new Copilot agent that target a specific document library or even a specific folder, what I can do is going on the homepage and clicking again on the command bar. By clicking here on this icon, I can open the Copilot agent, and now from the drop-down I can start the creation of a new Copilot agent, or I can jump in site contents and then target the document library where I want to create the new Copilot agent. And here in the command bar, just over the list, I have the option create an agent. By clicking on this, a new panel will open and this will create now a new agent targeting this document library as a source. Now let's click on the button Open Agent, and this will open immediately my Copilot agent, just called with a default name documents age. So you can change all these things, you can change the icon, the name of your agent. You may notice three pre-default options available as a prompt: summarize the selected file, create an FAQ from the selected file, suggest next steps from the selected file. So now what I can do here is clicking on the ellipsis button is of course share this Copilot agent and edit it. So I have the identity here as a column, and here now I can start to change the name of my agent. So I can call it just, let be original, FAQ agent, and I can select an image, a logo for my Copilot. It's fine to have this one. And then I can even change the description if I want. And another important thing that I can do is open Copilot Studio to customize this agent, but this agent will still live in SharePoint. Okay, let's say that everything looks good for identity. Now I can jump on sources, and here I can decide which site I would like to target. So I am in the global HR and I want to now target the document library documents, but of course I can add additional document libraries. Now let's say that it's fine to have documents, but of course I can add additional document library that I have on this global HR site, but it's fine to have documents here and all good. So I can now jump on the third option and columns, which is behavior. So here I can redesign the welcome message. I can change the prompts, summarize the selected file or create an FAQ from a selected, or provide useful info to get started on this site. All right, I changed this prompt now, and here I have on the right upper view. I can save it. I don't want to go now on Copilot Studio. Let's save this agent. And now I will show you something cool. So now the Copilot is created, and I wanna go now on documents. So the FAQ agent is created. A new file is dropped in this document library. Now, when I open here in the very upper right corner, Copilot, I can see the main agent that ground the global HR site, and I can see the agent just created FAQ agent. All right, now let me go again back on the documents library, and what I would like to do is download this file, because I want to show you this file how it looks like. So let me right click on it, and I'm going to use Visual Studio Code to open this file. So we can see here that this file is nothing else than a JSON file. So I have a plain text here selected for this site. I'm going to select JSON, and then I'm going to format this document. And as you can see, this is nothing else than a JSON. So I have several information on this file. I have the three options available in the prompts. I have the welcome message. I have the definition of this agent, the name, the description, instructions, and capabilities. This is an agent that targets this global HR site, more specific, this document library. This is the name, the site ID. So these are all references. And now, as a last attribute, I have the icon This is the image, Base64 image. So theoretically, I can change all this information directly from here, from this JSON, and re-upload this JSON to update my Copilot agent. All right, we have seen now how it looks, this file. I can delete this file, so my Copilot agent will be gone, and I can create a new one if I want. So now let's start doing something here. So first of all, I'm going to select this file, and now I will open again Copilot by clicking here. So then I'm going to target FAQ, and now I want to select a file. If I have here this file immediately, private channel FAQ, so I can select this one. Let's send this message, and now my new Copilot agent will create a FAQ from this specific file, which is an explanation of private channel in Teams. All right, this is now ready to go. I can close this file. Now, something that I would like to highlight here is that when I open Copilot, the Copilot panel, I can see that there is a little check mark here. It means that this agent is already available to all members of this site, but this one not. In fact, there's no check marks here. So what I can do is sharing this agent with other colleagues. So I can reopen the Copilot panel. I can select my new FAQ agent just created, and from the three dots I can click on share. This will give me the chance to play with this agent with my colleagues. So maybe this could be the scenario where we want to start to test this agent with other colleagues. And once we have done that, let's say that we are ready to make this Copilot agent available to everyone in the site. In order to publish this FAQ agent, all I need to do is jump on the site assets document library. Let's go in site content, site assets. Here I can see the new folder created, Copilots, because I created a new agent. And now, just to be sure that this document library site assets will be visible in the quick access panel, I will pin this. All right, now I can go back to the previous document library, which is documents. Now from here, I'm going to click on the ellipsis button next to the name of my agent, and I'm going to move this agent to the global HR site assets library. I'm going to click on Copilot and then approve it, and let's click on move here. Now this Copilot agent will keep every references that we have seen in the JSON file before. It means that this agent will still ground only this document library, nothing will change. But the only thing that will change is that now this file.agent will be stored under the approved folder. We can see now this file here. And this means that when I open the Copilot panel here, clicking on the proper icon, I can now see in the drop-down to select and to pick the agent, I can see the checkbox, the check mark here available. It means that this Copilot agent is now approved for this site, and every other member of this site will see this Copilot agent in the drop-down. Another consideration to make is that the first Copilot that we have seen before, the Global HR, this ground and target the entire site. If you have an upside, like in my case, because I have the global HR, but I have also other sites that are connected to this upside. So we can see from here, from the SharePoint Admin Center, that I created a learning, for example, a learning communication site. And this is connected to the global HR hub site. And it means that when I create the main agent that ground the entire site, this will ground also the other communication sites or SharePoint sites that are registered to the hub site. So this opens the door to other many scenarios. Imagine where you have a department hub site and just down below, just down the department communication site, you have many other SharePoint sites connected to it. So by using this approach, you can ground all sites connected to the hub site. I'm also able to customize this Copilot agent. Now that this one is dropped in the site assets and approved, I have another option available in the ellipses button next to Share, Edit and About. I have assigned as Site Default. This will change the agent that we created before with this one. And this would be the default agent that will target and ground the entire site. So by clicking again on this one, I have now my FAQ agent available. So I can edit again this one, and I can edit also and customize a bit this agent by using Copilot Studio. This is an important option that you have to bring more and to make your Copilot agent more spicy. I am now always in the document library documents, and what I would like to do is opening in the command bar create an agent panel. I can still target the documents as a document library, or I can jump into that folder, private channels, and here again I can click on create an agent. And now I'm targeting just this folder and not the entire document library. Now, considerations to make to wrap up this important topic are file supports from Copilot agents. Here I am in the official Microsoft documentation chat with agent in SharePoint. And as a supported file types, I have Office documents, of course, new M365 formats like Fluid and Loop, very, very cool. And this will cover the scenario in the future for meeting recordings or meeting notes. And then universal formats like PDF, TFT, web files, ASPX, HTML, and open documents format. In the future, there will be the support for images, meeting recordings, and other videos, and OneNote notebooks. Will come also in the future the ability to disable this capability or feature in the tenant. As an admin, there will be even this option. We have seen Copilot in SharePoint. If you enjoyed this video, please consider to subscribe, like, hit that subscribe button. I hope to see you next time.